In this video, we'll show you how to perform left bundle branch area pacing in a patient requiring His bundle ablation. A popular approach is with the C315 His guiding catheter, which is a non-deflectable guiding catheter with 7 French exterior diameter and is 43 centimeters in length. It is used to deliver the 3830 Select Secure pacing lead, also from Medtronic. It is very popular since the lead has no lumen and is therefore very thin, which allows for easy penetration of the interventricular septum. However, stylet-driven leads may also be used to perform left bundle branch area pacing. We have used an axillary venous approach, of which we have another video. Now the guiding catheter can be introduced into the heart, together with the dilator and the guide wire. In some cases, the guide wire can be kept in place to gain access to the RV in case when it was difficult to pass the tricuspid valve. But in most cases, this is not necessary. The dilator and guide wire can now be removed to allow insertion of the pacing lead. Note that this lead has an extended and fixed helix. It's very thin when compared to conventional pacing leads. The lead can now be introduced while making sure that the distal end does not exit the guiding catheter. Unipolar pacing helps in finding the area of interest, showing a W pattern in lead V1. On the fluoroscopy, we can see that the lead tip is against the high basal septum. Turning the fluoroscopy to RAO view reveals that the lead tip is pointing towards 2 o'clock. Now towards LAO view to make sure that the guiding catheter is placed perpendicular on the septum. Under a slight LAO view, the lead is advanced into the septum using a few quick turns. Note how on fluoroscopy the lead moves through the interventricular septum towards the LV endocardium. The lead is reconnected to the programmer, always in unipolar setup. The lead adequately senses the irregular ventricular rhythm. An injury current on the distal tip should be present, together with R waves. The impedance should be relatively high, associated with septal myocardium. Diminishing pacing outputs may expose changes in CRS morphology, revealing selective versus non-selective capture. In this case, no CRS changes are observed, which could help to distinguish between selective and non-selective LVP capture. The time from pacing artifact to peak in V6 or LVAD is 70 milliseconds in this case, suggesting LVP capture. Should be within 75 milliseconds in narrow QRS patients and within 80 milliseconds in patients with native wide QRS complexes. Another criterion of LVP capture is the R wave prime, lead V1. In this second case, with conduction disease after a TAVI procedure, some other features will be shown. Since the patient has LVP and the guiding catheter can bump into the RV and create a V-block, the atrial lead is temporarily placed in the RV to enable RV backup pacing. The guiding catheter